Titus chapter 1, verse 9. By the way, Titus chapter 1, beginning at verse 5, we have the requirements for elders. The biblical requirements for elders. At the end of those requirements, verse 9, he must hold firm to the trustworthy word as taught, so that he may be able to give instruction in sound doctrine and also to rebuke those who contradict it. That's my job description, folks. To know sound doctrine, to teach sound doctrine, and to rebuke those who contradict sound doctrine. That's my job. It's not a suggestion, it's a command. And any pastor who is not rebuking unsound doctrine is not doing his job.
In other words, Paul says, Timothy, if you're going to do the work in Ephesus, if you're going to strengthen the church, you too must silence those who teach error. And he says the same thing to Titus. Part of spiritual leadership is this. Silencing people who should not speak. Titus, it isn't enough to teach truth. You've got to silence certain people. We silence them by overpowering them with truth. We silence them with the truth. Jesus did that, and he did it over and over again with the Pharisees and the scribes and the Sadducees. They spewed out their human philosophy and their quasi-religious musings, and he cut them to shreds with divine truth. In Matthew 22:34, it says Jesus silenced the Sadducees. He shut their mouths because they became overpowered with truth. In other words, when we speak the truth so clear and precise, so apparent, and so powerful, those who have been teaching error run to hide in the embarrassment of their ineptitude. That's one way. It's wonderful to see some false teacher get a platform and then to see someone just present overpowering truth and watch that false teacher retreat. Now, people always ask me why I write controversial books. Well, this is one reason. I can't cut the tongue out of false teachers. I can't physically silence them. I can't take away their platform. I don't have any means to do that. But what I can try to do is to overpower their influence by teaching truth, so that people who read what they say and read what the Bible says are going to clearly see the error. You can knock the props out from under them by overpowering them with truth, and then hopefully watch them retreat. That's a very important thing to do. Anybody like the Apostle Paul who has a passion for truth will have a passion for silencing those who speak error. His letters, frankly, are full of this, dealing with error, dealing with deception, dealing with false prophets, false teachers. In fact, I was telling someone this week, they asked me, what are you preaching on Sunday? And I said, well, I'm preaching on false teachers. And they said, oh, you're into that again? And my response was, I'm into that because I'm into the New Testament and the New Testament is into that. It's all over the place. We certainly need to be continually warned about it, and the New Testament is not negligent to do that.